Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 13.4 Developer Beta 4. Now, the public beta may or may not be out by the time you're watching this. Based off last week, it should be out by the time you're watching it, or it could be the following day. Now, this one came in at 151.2 megabytes on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. It was about 150 megabytes on everything, including the iPad Pro 12.9 and my iPhone 6S Plus. Now, unfortunately, many people are having problems installing this particular update, including myself. So on my iPhone XR, if I try and install the update, it will tell me I don't have an internet connection. And so you'll see, give it just a moment, and it may work now, but it was saying that I didn't have an internet connection every time I was trying to update. So if it fails every time, then I'll use iTunes to update it. So I'll let this run here, and if it fails, I'll show you that. But it has been failing. Maybe it'll work now. But I've tried uninstalling and reinstalling the beta profile. I've tried rebooting and it wasn't working, but it might work now. And so it looks like it just rebooted on its own. So it's doing something else and has all sorts of issues. So there's something weird with the installation of this update. But other than that, if you were able to get it to install, it looks like it's working now. Let's go ahead and take a look at the build number. The build number is 17E5249A, and last time it was D, so we're getting closer and closer to the final release, which is good, and I expected the final release to be the end of this month, so I'll talk more about that toward the end of the video, but I thought it would be closer to the end. Now, Apple also released beta updates for macOS and tvOS, but no watchOS beta updates, so we're still on the last beta with watchOS. So if you have that, unfortunately, there's no update for it. There probably will be soon. Now, one update to other apps that a lot of people have been looking forward to is WhatsApp. So if I go into WhatsApp, you'll see we're on light mode. If I switch over to dark mode on the phone itself, WhatsApp will follow. So just make sure you're up to date with WhatsApp and you'll have that update if you're using that app. So that's a nice little change. Now, there was no modem update, but that's not really an issue for me personally because I've had no connectivity issues with this particular beta. So with beta 2 and 3, it's been fine. If I go off of Wi-Fi, back on, go to LTE, nothing really affects it anymore. It seems like Apple really fixed that issue. And good thing is my iPhone XR is finally working. So try it again. If it's not working, it should be now. Now, as far as the notes are concerned, there were two known issues. Those were the same known issues as last time. They're basically little minor issues. And then there was one resolved issue, and that was the same iPad keyboard fix from last time with languages and things like that. Now, the good thing is there's other fixes that are more noticeable, such as going into About. So if you go into About, it opens right up now. If you close that, it's fine. So that has been fixed. And then also audio when playing Apple TV app TV shows and movies has been fixed as well. And so if you're in the TV app, I'm not sure where I put it here. I think it's under entertainment, or it's under this folder here. If you're playing different video, you'll now have audio that's working properly. Now, as far as small changes that are in this, well, there's not a whole lot other than what I mentioned. So it looks like Apple's really nailing down fixes for this particular update and making sure it works properly before it's released to the public. And there is two more small tweaks that really aren't anything that important per se, but my friend Steve over at Mac Rumors, you'll see he posted this here on Twitter, and he noticed that the Apple Card's privacy policy has been updated. And if you really want to read this, follow him. You can find a ton of information in here in the privacy policy. Also, he noticed one other thing, and that is text for settings under the TV app. So if we go into the TV app here, let me find that. Here we go. And then if I go down to audio languages, default, this text has changed. So if I bring in an iPhone that's on a different version here, we'll go into settings, go to the same thing, and then go to audio languages. Let me switch here. You have the old version on the left and the new one on the right. The text has actually changed here. So it's not a big change, but it just says default language for a TV show or movie is determined by the original spoken language or by your region. It used to say default language for a TV show or movie is the primary language defined by your region. They're just tweaking text. It's nothing major, but something to note. And as far as other major changes, well, there's nothing else to mention as far as major changes in this update. So a couple little tweaks to text, a couple little tweaks to other things. And it also seems like rotation has been fixed. So if you have an iPhone 6S Plus, 7 Plus, or 8 Plus where you can rotate the home screen, that rotation is working. And it's also working well on the iPad Pro as well here. So you'll see if I rotate this, it's now working like it should be. But there are no new changes on iPadOS either, so this isn't really a very exciting update, but it is a bug fix update in this at this point. Now, I would expect new emoji and things by the time this is finally released, but in general, there's nothing else new. Nothing mentioned as far as security updates or anything else. I'm sure there's other tweaks and changes in it, but right now there's nothing physical you can see as far as anything in the control center or settings or anything else that I've been able to find so far. Now, as far as battery life on the previous beta has been fine on beta 3. It does take a few days to determine overall battery life over a few days. So if I go to the last 10 days, you'll see my use is pretty consistent. Yesterday I had 3 hours and 30 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 11 minutes of screen off time. Now you'll see I used it to about 40% or so. And if I continued to use it throughout the day, maybe I'd get about 7 hours of screen on time. But screen off time is big for me. I've been using my phone a lot for music and things like that. So it will take a few days to know how it is over time. But different days vary. I got almost 4 hours of screen on time with about 30% charge a few days ago and 1 hour and 43 minutes. I normally say about 10 to 12 hours of screen on time is what you should expect from these phones. Now, as far as performance and things like that, well, the little that we've had it for a couple hours now that it's been out on the 6S Plus, this is the oldest phone. So if it performs well on this phone, it should perform well on any of them. And I usually use Minecraft to sort of measure how fast things load. And so right now, there we go. It says unable to connect to world. Things are working quickly. We'll give it a moment here. And it loaded, and it seems like it's okay as far as frame rates. And that's what we're really looking for. Yes, a game can take forever to load, but it loaded in basically the same amount of time and frame rates are solid. And that's what we're looking for on games. And of course, this is not a very intensive game, but it's just one way to measure performance. So things like loading music and scrolling and scroll speeds seem to be better. Now, beta 3, a lot of people had some app lockups and things like that, but it seems like it's working better now. And this one in particular finally updated on my iPhone XR. Now that it's back up, I'll run a Geekbench on the iPhone XR while we take a look at the scores on the 11 Pro Max, and then we'll compare all of them. So we'll make sure everything's closed. We'll run the benchmark, let that run in the background, and let's take a look at the Geekbench scores on the 11 Pro Max. Now on the 11 Pro Max, I scored 1,322 for single core and 3,389 for multi-core score. So that's okay. It's not amazing, but we'll take a look at the history here. Now on February 26th, you'll see that the single core was a little bit higher, but the multi-core is actually lower than this time by a couple hundred. So we're doing a little bit better now. And in general, your device should feel pretty fast. It really had no slowdowns for me on beta 3. So beta 4 should be the same, but it will take a few days to know that for sure, like I said before, and I'll be sure to do a follow-up. Now let's take a look at all of the devices so you can compare what you have with what I'm getting on these devices. Now from left to right, we have the iPad Pro 12.9 from 2018, then the iPhone 6S Plus, the iPhone XR, and then the iPhone 11 Pro Max. And so this should give you an idea of how your device is performing compared to these. Now these scores generally do go up a little bit as all of the background tasks complete. And so if you check it in a few hours, it'll probably be a little bit better. But let me know what yours is in the comments below. Now, as far as the actual final release of iOS 13.4, I would expect it at the end of this month, although having an A at the end of the build number means it could be only a week or two away. So it's possible we see beta up to beta 6 or 7, but it seems unlikely that they'll do that this time. It's really hard to say. But if there is an event on the 31st, as many people think there will be, then I would expect it the same day. If not, maybe there'll be something else. So it's really hard to say. And then again, as I've mentioned many times before, iOS 14 should be shown in June at WWDC, the Worldwide Developer Conference. And that's where we'll see the major changes. So I'm really looking forward to a final release of this, along with all of the new expected products, such as MacBooks and iPads and things like that, the iPhone 9 or SE 2. But hopefully we'll have a final very stable version of iOS 13.4 within a couple weeks, and that would be great for everyone's experience. So in general, I would expect that to be out soon. And let me know if you've found any other features in the comments below. I'll be sure to mention those in upcoming follow-up videos that I usually do on Sunday, and I'll run a poll on the YouTube community page so that you can actually tell me how it's going for you and what device you're using it on. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.